Others are members of the board, trustee Bromarino.
I have none.
Trustee Abraham.
I do, again, thank you for looking into this situation on there. Obviously, there's more traffic flow in our community, so I'm glad we're being aware of it and making adjustments to it. Thank you again on this.
Trustee Moore.
No comment.
Trustee Brewer. Trustee Hughes.
Not only that, I fully understand the need for stop sign there, but I was thinking if we put an ME in that fire truck.
Mayor, would you like to weigh in on the stop sign on Main?
No, thank you.
Okay. Mr. Clerk, would you like to roll call?
Okay, roll call, trustee Ely.
Yes.
Trustee Brewer.
Yes.
Trustee Jones.
Aye.
Trustee Moore.
Yes.
Trustee Abraham.
Yes.
Trustee Bromarino.
Yes.
Motion carries 6-0. This item on the agenda, item E, an ordinance authorizing and approving acceptance of the lowest responsible bid of J. Erdely Concrete Inc. for the Village of Broadview, County of Cook, State of Illinois.
Approve.
Second.
Okay, this has been properly motioned by trustee Abraham, seconded by trustee Moore. Open for discussion.
Okay, this ordinance approves the lowest responsible bid for the 2017 alley improvement project from J. Erdely Concrete Incorporated in accordance with the recommendation provided by Hancock Engineering. Hancock is happy to be in the room tonight. Article 7, Section 10, A of the Illinois Constitution authorizes units of local government to contract or otherwise associate with individuals, associations, and corporations in any manner not prohibited by law or by ordinance. The solicitation of bids for the project was required by and conducted in accordance with all applicable state laws, including Section 8-9-1 of the Illinois Municipal Code, 65 ILCS 5/8-9-1. Comments from the members of the board relative to this bid approval, trustee Bromarino.
Just that this, I don't remember if you just said this. This is our CDBG project. So part of this is being paid with Community Development Block Grant Funds. That's all.
Does that interest trustee Bromarino?
That's all.
Trustee Abraham.
Just a quick thing to Mr. Hancock, Brandon Hancock Engineering. This is for one project, and they didn't meet all the requirements from my understanding. I see the proposal amount, so.
Yes, this is for doing the alley between 22nd and 23rd, between 21st and 22nd, in the alley north of Roosevelt to fill. Two alleys there. There's going to be some permeable pavers put in down the middle of the alley to collect some of the rain wire to reduce the flow down the water's combined sewer system. And the green infrastructure is incorporated. We did the one alley last year. The village got a bigger grant this year, so we were able to do two alleys, and the grant's covering probably $270,000 out of construction. Generally, he's done that in the past. It's good work.
No comment, thank you.
Okay, trustee Brewer, trustee Hughes.
No, I have nothing, thank you.
Jim, did you use something from your turn before you talk about Hancock? Madam President, do you have anything to add to this one?
No, I don't.
Okay, neither do I. We have a roll call.
Mr. Cannon, trustee Ely.
Yes.
Trustee Brewer.
Yes.
Trustee Jones.
Aye.
Trustee Moore.
Yes.
Trustee Abraham.
Yes.
Trustee Bromarino.
Yes.
And this carries 6-0. Next item on the agenda, application for the authority to expend funds. We have none. I have 10, notice clerk. I just have a couple of things. First off, I want to thank both police and fire chiefs for participation for your departments in the National Night Out. It was an awesome time. It was good to see all of the participation that happened with our jacks, the attack of the demonstration. Chief Ugling got in the dunk tank. He got soaked several times.
Okay.
And next year we're going to get Chief Kenya. I want to thank the finance director, Tim Hicks, for recently having a discussion with me. He recommended a software that he's familiar with. And the purpose of the software was basically, and I don't have a full understanding of everything it does, but it would consolidate our ability to enter contracts and ordinances into the software for purposes of transparency and organization. So I don't know all the full details about it yet. I have the paperwork, I'm gonna do more research on it, and asking the assistance of our village administrator, Mr. Jones, to assist me in going through that to see how it would benefit our village. And with that being said, that concludes my report.
Okay, Madam President, the floor is yours. If you'd like me to go over the public comments, so you can respond to them, I will. If not, the floor belongs to you.
Yes, let's address some of the public comments.
Okay, so the first public comment was from Judy Brown Moreno regarding her request for presentation, and she talked about solar energy and leasing space on the roof from us, and why she didn't give us the information, why the guy was reluctant to put it in writing to the village.
Okay, well, when Trustee Brown Moreno reached out to me, she did say that she wants to have a meeting with me, but I asked her if it was right, and she failed to give me what the details were. I asked her if she had a proposal, what was it that we could do. She refused to give up any documentation. So with her refusing to give up any documentation or proposals or email or contact, I didn't know what the content of the meeting was, so therefore I denied her request to have a meeting with me. So that's the first thing. But you don't tell the story, tell the whole story, Trustee Brown Moreno, that you were reluctant to give up any information pertaining to what your request was about. And that makes that relate to the building department. You knew that the building department was in transition with the renovation to that department because of lack of negligence on the former board members, and that's in the condition that building was in.
Yeah, and we have a process, and we have a process.
Okay, now what's the second?
The second one was regarding the audit. When Ms. Redman talked about where the audit was with Mr. Hicks, and the fact that she had requested fund balances going up to April of 17, and revenues from the month of May, and then she had asked for this info, and that Mr. Peters presented it in every meeting, and then she asked about the financing meeting, but I think he may have responded to her in kind, I don't know. But that was what her comments were.
Okay, Mr. President, as stated before, we are in transition with the new administrative team trying to put the best practices in place. Maybe before it was very easy to get information, but as you can tell, as you heard through the rest of the history before, I hope they kind of clarified some of the concerns that may have been arise. Hopefully we can get the information to the clerk office so we need to give to you. It's not that we hold it, it's just a process. Okay, and then
Maxine Johnson had three points that she made. One of them was about the pro tem. I don't know if you need to respond to that. The other one was about the website and the ability to do meetings. And then the last thing was about the finances of the village and spending, current spending practices.
Okay, so Ms. Johnson,
as
we made sure the copy that was made about the conditions of our finances are not the issue. What the issue is as it relates to the finances, the condition of our books, I do not be opposed to timely and putting the best internal controls. So when I say the financial wreck, that's what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about as it relates to money. The former mayor, now Trustee Brown, he did an excellent job making sure that we had funds available. He took us all of the deficits. So kudos to him for making sure that we can function in the financial capacity that we are able to do a lot of the things that we're doing right now is because of what he implemented in the past. So when I talk about the conditions of the finances, I'm talking about the conditions of our books, the internal control, and things not being posted. That's keeping us from, you know, we spend more time in the audit than we probably should in the field work. We have just due diligence prior to it. We could have been ahead of the game, but we had the setback. You know, the barriers did come up, and that's okay. So, as it relates to the website, I think Trustee Moore may want to sign in on the website to give an update on the website.
Yeah, I can give one. Our low light date is scheduled for September 19th. We did experience a delay, and the delay was because we needed to assess the equipment that was available to facilitate live streaming. So I wasn't confident that the equipment that we currently have in place will enable us to stream the board meetings live versus it being pre-recorded. And so because of that reason alone, it got delayed. But we are scheduled to go live on September 18th with all functionality in place.
Okay,
then, okay, then you had resident Diane Little, she made a comment about the Lions Club.
You missed one, the money for the baseball, right? The third one was.
Oh, the money for the baseball, well.
Oh, okay, so, let me, because she did mention that.
She did mention that.
So the Little League baseball, the check was issued to Little League baseball, you may want to follow up with them to see if they actually got the check, but we did cut the check was there.
I did.
Yeah, okay.
I did, they didn't receive anything, so that's why I posed the question at this board meeting.
Yeah, yeah, well, thanks, Maxine. Moving on to Diane Little's comment, she made a comment about the Lions Club on September 28th with the free hearing and vision, but she posed two questions. One was with the clerk's office regarding the Chamber of Commerce, and the second question was regarding neighborhood watch and how she can get more information about each.
Okay, so with the Chamber of Commerce, actually, that's my function of the Bob administration, we working on some things to put some things in paper that we can bring to Raleigh Chamber of Commerce. Currently, that's a separate entity from the village, so we're trying to bring that under the umbrella of the village. I know the clerk has been involved with the Chamber of Commerce, that was a conversation probably to have with clerk of career. As it relates to the neighborhood watch, our next department head meeting, we can bring that up in our department head meeting with the supervisors on the neighborhood watch. So, which we posted.
And then you had Marquita Smith, who made a comment thanking them about attending the congressman parade. She requested a copy of the warrant list, I do believe we provided that for her. She spoke about the lobbyist once again and about the reason why we have them and the cost and expense of having a lobbyist. And then she inquired about the stop signs, which we just approved.
Okay, so this is something to back on the lobbyist, because I think you're one of the requests I just heard as it relates to lobbying. But if you do your homework and do your research, you will see that most successful villages have lobbyists. Actually, Congressman Dan Davis has lobbyists, so you've seen that one too.
Yep.
So when we talk about being how it's successful, the lobbyist is not for the mayor's office, the lobbyist is for the village of Brockville. And when I speak of the village of Brockville, I'm talking about our fire department, our police department, our building department, and our public works department. Those are the people that need the lobbyists in place. So if we look at funding and how we get opportunities, we rely on the lobbyists to bring legislation to us and how we can be proactive and allow the initiatives to take place at the state level. So once again, you may see it as a waste of money, but it's not. I think it's a waste of money to get all these people being the lawsuits.
Okay, that's it, Madam President. Any final words from you?
No, I just want to thank all of our students throughout the village of Brockview. It's a very successful academic school year. It's really the greatest in our population. We will continue to work hard and be proactive, and we all just need to start to work together, even in our business, and being a free adventure, and we should be okay with that. So that's
it
for tonight's
advice. Motion to adjourn.
Second.
So properly motion by Trustee Jones, second by Trustee Brewer to adjourn the meeting at
9:40.
9:40 p.m. All
in
favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay. We're not
positioned to adjourn. Good night, Madam President.
All right, now.
I'm going to go to the next one.
straight across.
Yes, and that was stuck, it was the turn lane.
Yes.
So what's the deal? She just wants to sit there and dance? So we use all of this? So what do you want to say?
So we really shouldn't say.
I know. I don't play basketball. So if they were listening to that.